Hi, everyone. This is Scott Bowsom, Legislative Director at the National Office of the Enlisted Association of the National Guard of the United States. It is Wednesday, May 30th, and just wanted to provide a quick update for the June weekend drill weekend talking points. Earlier this month, Wednesday, May 9th, to be precise, the House Armed Services Committee marked up the FY19 National Defense Authorization Act. As many of you know already, this office has been working really hard to expand TRICARE Reserve Select to eligible federal employees. There is a video posted to this drill weekend talking point that it shows Congressman Kelly of Mississippi, who introduced an amendment, which is a mirror copy of his language for H.R. 5121, which you've seen a legislative alert on. There's about a 3-minute blurb from that markup of him debating the legitimacy of the policy. It was unsuccessfully adopted. In fact, he actually withdrew the amendment during the markup earlier this month because of the mandatory cost associated with this effort. It was basically what we were trying to do, what the congressman was trying to do, was increase pharmacy copays for mail-in order prescriptions by a dollar. And that would have covered the $240 million mandatory price tag. Now, one thing that we continue to talk about, I do, and folks on the Hill who are in support, is this policy actually saves $1.2 billion in discretionary spending that the Department of Defense would realize, because the offsets that the federal government provides for healthcare on TRICARE Reserve Select are much smaller than they are for these folks who are in the Federal Employee Health Benefit Plan. So that continues to be one talking point. The continuity of care that the service member is able to appreciate whenever they go on Title 10 orders is probably our biggest talking point, and in addition to the cost savings. So we're continuing to fight this fight. The Senate Armed Services Committee has marked up their version of the bill. This provision is not in the Senate committee's position. They will be going to the floor, the Senate floor, in June, and we anticipate this amendment being considered and actually adopted. Although, because it is an election year, and again, the mandatory cost of increasing those copays by a dollar is not very palatable, and so I could imagine, as other advocates can imagine, that by the time the House and Senate conference the National Defense Authorization Act, that this will not be an issue that is adopted in the president's signed version later this year. I will say that from a strategic perspective, we have about 38 co-sponsors for H.R. 5121, and we are trying and we are continuing to meet with other representatives to try to get them to co-sponsor the bill, so that moving forward into the 116th Congress in a non-election year, that if they do make adjustments to mandatory spending, whether it's copay fees or anything else, that one of the issues that they address is TRICARE Reserve Select expansion. And we're doing the exact same thing in the Senate side. The last I checked, there's 15 senators that support the Senate version of the language introduced by Senator Hatch. So continue to check back with us. We'll continue to keep you updated. A lot of good things going on this year. Things are moving really fast in D.C. as members of the House and Senate prepare for elections this summer and fall. And we're continuing to do great work for you. And stay in touch. Thanks.